In the past weeks, the Bitcoin bulls have shown great strength, pushing BTC's price back into the $50. In the meantime, the members of the U.S. government have reopened a Pandora box in an attempt to elevate their debt ceiling, to mint a $1 trillion coin and prevent it from defaulting on their national debt. Related reading: Fed chair says still working on digital dollar as China pulls ahead. The scenario where the U.S. decides to issue a $1 trillion coin could have devastating consequences for the global economy due to the status of the USD as the global reserve currency, Onge said the following on the chaos that could ensue. The end result of a $1 trillion coin is radically higher money creation, radically higher government absorption of real resources from the private sector, and a federal government that has finally maxed out the credit card once and for all, bringing them at last face to face with the universe's ultimate debt ceiling, the bond market. The fact that the discussion to mint a $1 trillion coin is actually being considered by the U.S. government is already a bullish factor for Bitcoin, the research claimed. BTC was created as a result of a financial crisis and a lack of trust in the central authorities that rule over the global monetary supply. In that sense, Bitcoin operates as insurance, a way to opt out of a system that seems to be trapped in a pattern of destroying the world every decade, as Onge said. Inflation, one of the main problems that came out of the COVID-19, could be significantly worse if handled by other branches of the U.S. government. The research said, if you think central banks like printing money, just wait till you meet Congress. And, as corollary, if Bitcoin's price likes the Fed's money printers, wait till they meet a treasury that shoots out $1 trillion scrip for sport. Ultimately, Onge rules out the possibility of a $1 trillion coin, but its symbol of inflation and lack of trust in the government stands. Thus, it becomes just another reason to hold Bitcoin.